Hello and welcome to this video. My name is Shamsuddin. In this video, we're going to look at exporting animations from Blender to DAW Studio. So I'm going to start by loading a Genesis 8 basic female. So because I am only looking to use imported animations from Blender using this figure, there is absolutely no need to add any clothing or any other accessory to this figure, as that sometimes creates extra bones on the armature and that interferes with the animation. It prevents the animation from copying correctly. So now I can just go ahead and export this figure by going to File up here and then select Export. Here I'm going to rename the file to Genesis 8 Female and then save it as Autodex FBX and then again click Accept. Alright, now I'm going to open up Blender. I already have it open on my second screen. I'm just going to drag it to this screen and then expand. You can see I'm working with Blender 3.4. Alright, so now I'll delete this cube, press N for the properties panel, select the Rig-GNS tab. This you can see is the Rig-GNS Pro version 3.6. Okay, so now I'm just going to click this large import button, then go to the folder where I saved the file and import that. Okay, let me zoom in on this. Now I'm going to come to this rigging buttons down here. I'm going to start the rigging process by clicking the Add Meta Rig, then Match Rig, and then Generate Rig. And finally rig figure. Alright, now with the figure fully rigged, I'm going to expand the Animixer tab here. So this is in previous version of the add-on called the Animations tab, but the tab is now called Animixer. And this Animixer tab is mostly used for animating figures with animations from Mixamo or DAW Studio. So to get Mixamo animation, I'll simply click the Get Mixamo button. This launches the Mixamo website. I already have it open on this tab. Now I'm just going to quickly download this Roomba dancing animation. I'll go ahead and click download here. Have this as without skin and then click download again. All right. Now I'm going to go back to Blender, click this import Mixamo button. And let me expand this panel so you can see it says import. I'll click that to import the Mixamo animation. Then go to my download folder where I have it and import that. And then click bind to bind the animation to the figure. And now I'm going to play the animation. Exporting Mixamo animation to DAW is pretty straightforward, because once you have the animation bound to the figure, there's no need to bake the animation with the bake button here. So I'll just go ahead and export the animation directly by going to File and then Export, then DAW BVH, select that. Specify a folder. Now I'll rename the file Roomba Dancing and then click Export DAW BVH. Now I'll wait for that to export, and there you can see it says BVH animation exported, so I'll click OK. Now I'll switch back to DAW, go to File and then select Import. Here is the animation, select it and then select Open. In the BVH export option, I'll just click Accept. Alright, now I'll bring up the timeline pane. You can see the keyframes are already mapped on the timeline. Now when I play the animation, we shall see that the Roomba dancing animation is mapped almost perfectly except for the foot sliding around. And this is happening because there's a limit rotation constraint on these bones. The bones in DAW figures are made to mimic that of a real human being, and there are certain degrees you can rotate or twist the bones in your body, and DAW figure tends to behave in that manner. Now to disable the rotation limits on all bones, I will first need to go to the scene pane which I have over here, right click on the figure, then select and then select all. Now when I go back to the viewport, you can see all these bones are selected. Now I'll go to edit, then go to figure, and here where it says limits, I'm going to change this to limit off rotation. So this usually takes some seconds. Okay, so now when I hit play, you can see that the foot is no longer sliding. Now the animation is exactly as it was in Blender. And let me again go back to Blender so we can confirm that. Alright, so that is one way of exporting animation from Blender to DAW when using Mixamo animation. Another way is when exporting keyframe animations after animating the figure using IK and FK bones. So let me demonstrate that by first removing the animation by clicking the remove button here in the panel. And now I'm going to quickly animate this figure in time lapse, but first I'll have to go to pose mode. I also need to have my IK bones enabled by clicking the buttons here in the panel which toggles between IK and FK bones. Now I have the IK bones visible, but one other thing I need to do is drag up the timeline here so I can see the keyframes when I start animating the figure. I'll also go to keying here and set it to location and rotation, and also I'm going to turn on automatic keying. Now I'm going to select the hip bone, I will then press I to insert a keyframe. You can see the keyframe appears on the timeline. Alright, so now I'll go ahead and animate this figure in time lapse. Okay, so it doesn't have to be perfect. I think this is good enough to demonstrate exporting keyframe animation. Now I will click the match frame button. And what this does is it adjusts the timeline to match the length of the animation. And you should see when I click the match frame button, it adjusts the timeline, which makes the end frame 54. Let me play the animation one more time. Now, when satisfied with the animation, which I am, I will then select this bake animation button here in the panel. And immediately it prompts that baking animation for DAZ will render the rig unusable. I will go ahead and press OK, and this will take some minutes. Okay, so now you can see the button reads baked for DAZ 3D, which means the animation is now baked. Now this rig is unusable, and you should be able to see that when I try to animate the hip bone. You can see it no longer deforms correctly, it's all chaotic. So if you need to use the rig again, all you have to do is undo the last command by pressing Ctrl Z. Alright, now with this baked for DAZ, I'll go ahead and export the animation by going to File, and then Export, then DAZ BVH. I'll rename this to Keyframe Animation, and then click Export DAZ BVH. Alright, now wait for that to finish. Alright, then click OK. I'll switch back to DAZ again. I'll take this to the first frame. I'll then right click on the timeline pane here, Clear Animation, and then select Clear Figure to clear the previous animation. Now I will import the animation by going to File, then Import. Here is the keyframe animation I just exported from Blender. Now I'm just going to click Open and of course click Accept. Alright, so since I know that the animation ends at the 54th frame in Blender, so I'm going to also make the total frame range here 54 and then click Play. So now you can see that what we animated in Blender is mapped here in DAZ. So that is how to export animations from Blender to DAZ. I hope you found this video useful. If so, please like the video, and if you're new to the channel and would like to see videos on character animation using Blender and DAZ Studio, please consider subscribing to the channel. It really helps me a lot. Thank you for your time. Till next time.